लाप्लेस ट्रांसफॉर्म्स। सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस यू माइट हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस। सो व्हेन यू वर सॉल्विंग द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस यू यूज टू फाइंड आउट द पर्टिकुलर फंक्शन एंड द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री फंक्शन। यू यूज टू फाइंड द पर्टिकुलर इंटेग्रल्स, कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री फंक्शंस एंड देन द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस वर सॉल्वड। बट इन द लैपलेस ट्रांसफॉर्म्स वी कैन सॉल्व द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विद बाउंड्री वैल्यूज। Only boundary values are necessary for solving the differential equations, and we are not required to find the general solution and the arbitrary constant values. So Laplace transforms is very useful in solving the differential equations. So this is the base main benefit of using the Laplace transforms, that we can solve the differential equations without finding the general solution, and the differential equation solution is there with us. So the definition of the Laplace transform is that if suppose we have a function ft is a function which is defined for all positive values of t. जैसे कि आपके पास आप लिखते होते थे y square plus mx, तो आपका y जो है दैट इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ x. सिमिलरली वी हैव ft, वेयर ft इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ t एंड इट इज डिफाइंड फॉर ऑल द पॉजिटिव t. सो व्हेन वी इंटेग्रेट द फंक्शन ft, इंटेग्रल भी कैसा है हमारा, दैट द इंटेग्रल इज 0 टू इंफिनिटी e टू द पावर माइनस st ft dt. तो ये जो इंटेग्रल है हमारा that is 0 to infinity e to the power minus st ft dt, ये जो इंटेग्रल है आपका, this integral is called as f of s. Why this is regarded as f of s? F of s भी कैसा है, that is capital F and in the bracket it is a function of s. Why? Because when you will put the value of ft, that is it is an equation in t, and you will integrate the function and the limits is for t. The 0 to infinity limits are for t. So when you will put the value of t, the upper limit and the lower limit, the resultant equation that will be left out will be in s. So the function that is left out is in the s equation. So that is why the new function that will be obtained after integrating the function is written as f of s, means the resultant is a function of small s. Whatever s you are using, the function of, so f of s is a function for s, and this f of s is called transform of f of t, and this will exist only if the integral is existing, means it should not tend to infinity. The integral should have a value. So this is called, f of s is called the Laplace transform of f of t. So how do we denote the Laplace transform of f of t? Either we write L and in the bracket we write f of t. So one way is to write L of f t, or we can also use f of s. So L of f t is equal to f of s, and that is equal to integral 0 to infinity e to the power minus st ft dt. So you should always remember the definition of the Laplace transform of a function, which is defined as the integral e to the power minus st ft dt, and the limits are from 0 to infinity. So there are certain important formulas of the Laplace transform. So let us one by one calculate the formulas of the Laplace transform. So the first formula is that the function, if our function is a constant function, let the constant function be 1, and we want to calculate the Laplace of 1. So the answer that should come out will be Laplace of 1 is 1 upon s, means the function f of t is 1. So when you put f of t equal to 1, so Laplace of 1 will be 0 to infinity e to the plus st 1 into dt. सो इट इज सिंपल इंटेग्रल ऑफ ई टू द पावर माइनस एस टी. सो इंटेग्रल ऑफ ई टू द पावर माइनस एस टी इज ई टू द पावर माइनस एस टी अपॉन माइनस एस एंड द लिमिट्स आर फ्रॉम जीरो टू इंफिनिटी. नाउ इन द टी वैल्यू सब्स्टिट्यूट द अपर लिमिट एंड द लोअर लिमिट. सो यू गेट ई टू द पावर माइनस इंफिनिटी माइनस ऑफ ई टू द पावर माइनस जीरो एंड माइनस वन बाय एस कम्स आउट कॉमन. ई टू द पावर माइनस इंफिनिटी ई टू द पावर माइनस इंफिनिटी कैन बी रिटन एज वन अपॉन ई की पावर इंफिनिटी एंड एनीथिंग रेज टू पावर इंफिनिटी इज इंफिनिटी. सो यू गेट वन बाय इंफिनिटी. सो यू गेट इंफिनिटी इज जीरो and anything raised to power 0 is 1. So you get minus 1 by s, 0 minus 1, which is equal to 1 by s. So the Laplace of 1 is 1 by s. So now we are calculating the Laplace of e ki power at. So we put the function ft is equal to e ki power at in the definition of the Laplace transform. So we get 0 to infinity e to the power minus st e to the power at into dt. So we have 0 to infinity e is common, base common, so powers are added and we take negative common also. So we get e to the power minus of s minus a and t is common from both the exponentials into dt. So integrating the function, we get e to the power minus of s minus a into t upon minus of s minus a and the limits are from 0 to infinity. So substituting the limits values in the t function, we get minus of 1 upon s minus a is common. We get e to the power minus infinity, e to the power minus 0. Again, e to the power minus infinity is 0 and e to the power minus 0 is 1. So minus minus becomes plus. So we get the answer as 1 upon s minus a. So now we have two formulas, that is Laplace of 1 is 1 by s. And Laplace of e to the power at is 1 upon s minus a. Now, when you put t ki power n in your definition of the Laplace transform, you get 0 to infinity e to the power minus st t ki power n into dt. So now what you see that e to the power minus st and t ki power n both have the functions of t. So you will have to solve the integral as u into v. So since t is having a power of t ki power n, so the integral will be very, very lengthy and you will have to use the recurrence formulas. But you have already studied about the gamma functions. So in this formula, we shall be making use of the gamma function. Now what we do in this integral, we substitute st is equal to y. You were having the integral e to the power minus st. So substitute st equal to y. So t will be equal to y upon s. So dt is equal to dy upon s. As you know, the limits are t is equal to 0, so y will also be 0. And when t is infinity, y will also be infinity. So there is no change in the limits. So on making the following substitutions, the integral becomes Laplace of t ki power n is equal to integral 0 to infinity e to the power minus s in place of t. You have substituted y by s. And for t ki power n, you are substituting y by s raised to power n. In place of dt, you are substituting dy by s. So in the exponential, ss gets cancelled. You get e to the power minus y, y to the power n. अपॉन एस टू द पावर एन प्लस वन इंटू डी वाई. सिंस एस कैन बी ट्रीटेड एज कॉन्स्टेंट इट इज टेकन आउट ऑफ द इंटेग्रल. सो वॉट इज लेफ्ट आउट इन द इंटेग्रल यू हैव ई टू द पावर माइनस वाई वाई टू द पावर एन इंटू डी वाई. एंड यू मस्ट बी रिमेम्बरिंग द गामा फंक्शन दैट द गामा फंक्शन वॉज जीरो टू इन्फिनिटी टू द पावर माइनस एक्स एक्स की पावर एन डी एक्स. That was equal to gamma of n plus 1. And gamma of n plus 1 is equal to n factorial. So we can write the Laplace of t to the power n is gamma of n plus 1 upon s raised to power n plus 1. Or it could be written as n factorial upon s to the power n plus 1. So we have calculated three formulas. Laplace of 1 is 1 by s. Laplace raised to power at, e to the power at is 1 upon s minus a. Laplace of t to the power n is n factorial upon s raised to power n plus 1. This, the formulas for Laplace of cos at, that is hyperbolic cos function, cos of at, and the Laplace of hyperbolic sine function, that is sine of at. So we know that the hyperbolic cos function can be expressed as e to the power at plus e to the power minus at by 2. So we write Laplace of cos at is Laplace of e to the power at plus e to the power minus at by 2. So now we can split the two values. We can write it as half Laplace of e to the power at plus half Laplace of e to the power minus at. In the previous formula, we have already calculated Laplace of e to the power at. What was the formula? The formula was 1 upon s minus a. S minus a. And here it is Laplace of e to the power minus at. So it will become 1 upon s minus of minus a. So you get 1 upon s minus a and 1 upon s plus a. By solving it, you can take half common. Rationalizing it, you get s plus a minus a upon s minus a into s plus a. So a gets cancelled, you get 2s upon s square minus a square, because s minus a s plus a is s square minus a square. So 2 gets cancelled. So the formula for the Laplace of hyperbolic cos at is s upon s square minus a square. Similarly, we can calculate for the hyperbolic sine function. So hyperbolic sine function is expressed as e to the power at. In the cos, there was positive term. We were adding the two exponentials. But in the sine, hyperbolic sine function, we subtract the two functions. So it is e to the power at minus of e to the power minus at by 2. Again, substituting the value of sine of at, we write it as Laplace of e to the power at minus of e to the power minus at by 2. Again, we split it up into two parts. We get half of Laplace e to the power at, half of Laplace of e to the power minus at. Laplace of e to the power at is again 1 upon s minus a. E to the power minus at Laplace is 1 upon s minus of minus a. Half is again taken out constant. So you get s plus a minus of s minus a. So solving it, you get now s gets cancelled. You get 2a upon s square minus a square upon 2. Again, 2 gets cancelled. You get Laplace of hyperbolic sine of at is a upon s square minus a square. So you can see the formulae for the Laplace of cos at and the Laplace of sin at, that is s upon s square plus a square and a upon s square plus a square, is very, very similar to what you have derived earlier. The basic difference is only in the negative sign in the denominator. In the hyperbolic function, you are having s square minus a square, but in the trigonometry function, you are having in the denominator s square plus a square. So now, the cos of at can be written as e ki power iota at plus e to the power minus iota at. You know that cos anything e to the power iota theta is written as cos theta plus iota sine theta, and e to the power minus iota theta is written as cos theta plus iota sine theta. So we are just adding and subtracting the two e to the power iota theta and e to the power minus iota theta. So when we add, we get cos of at is e to the power iota at plus e to the power minus iota at by 2. And sine of at is e to the power iota at minus of e to the power minus iota at by 2 iota. So working on the same line as we calculated in the hyperbolic cos function, so Laplace of cos at can be written as Laplace of e ki power iota at plus e to the power minus iota at by 2. Again, breaking the bracket into two parts, we calculate the Laplace for e ki power iota at and Laplace of e ki power minus iota at. We know whatever is the coefficient of exponential of e, the term associated with t is subtracted from s. S minus iota a upon s minus iota a. So in the denominator, you get a plus b into a minus b. So it will be a square minus b square. So it will be iota a ka whole square. So you know iota square is minus 1. So minus minus becomes positive. So it becomes 2s upon 2 into s square plus a square. So 2 2 gets cancelled. You get s upon s square plus a square. Similarly, when we move for sine of at, we have a negative sign. The calculation is similar. Here what happens? The s gets cancelled. So 2, 2 gets cancelled. Iota also gets cancelled. So you are left out with a upon s square plus a square. So hence, the Laplace of cos at is s upon s square plus a square, and Laplace of sine at is a upon s square plus a square. The very simple method to remember this formula is that in the cos term, cos, sir ki awaaz aa rahi hai, cos, hai na? To aapka jo cos wale hai, chahe wo hyperbolic cos hai, chahe wo cos hai, trigonometric cos function hai, दोनों के न्यूमरेटर में स आएगा तो एस आएगा, ठीक है. एंड इन द साइन फंक्शन यू हैव ए इन द न्यूमरेटर, आइदर इट इज हाइपरबोलिक और इट इज अ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री साइन फंक्शन. एंड यू नो दैट कॉस स्क्वेर्ड थीटा प्लस साइन स्क्वेर्ड थीटा इज इक्वल टू 1, है ना. यू नो दैट कॉस स्क्वेर्ड थीटा प्लस साइन स्क्वेर्ड थीटा इज इक्वल टू 1. देयर इज अ पॉजिटिव साइन in the addition of cos square and sin square. So in the denominator also you have a positive sign here. So it is s square plus a square. Whereas in the hyperbolic function, the formula is x minus sin square x is equal to 1. There is a negative sign between hyperbolic cos and sine. So in the denominator of the hyperbolic cos and sine, you have a negative sign. So it is s square minus a square. So you can remember the formula that in the trigonometry sine and cos, there is a positive sign because cos square theta plus sine square theta equal to 1. Whereas in the hyperbolic cos and sine, the denominator is carrying a negative sign. It is s square minus a square because cos square x minus sine square x is equal to 1. So you can relate the positive and negative signs to the formulas also. Now there is a question for you. This is a question that you have to find the Laplace of the function. The function is defined as t square when t is lying between 0 to 2, ft is t minus 1, when t is from 2 to 3, and ft is 8, when t is greater than 3. So for such a function ft, you have to calculate the Laplace of f of t. Now you know that Laplace of ft is 0 to infinity integral e to the power minus st ft dt. Your limits is starting from 0 and it is ending to infinity. And when you see your function, the t is also varying from 0 to 2, 2 to 3, and the last limit is t greater than 3. Means the value of t is extending from 3 to infinity and the function will have the value of 8. So now we will split the integral into three parts. So we will have the integral 0 to 2 e to the power minus st t square dt. For the first limit 0 to 2, we put ft is equal to t square. When we put the limit 2 to 3, so we will substitute the ft as t minus 1. And when we put 3 to infinity, we will put the function value ft is equal to 8. So we get three functions. We get 0 to 2 e to the power minus st t square dt plus integral 2 to 3 t minus 1 e to the power minus st dt plus integral 3 to infinity 8 into e to the power minus st dt. Now when we look to the first two integrals, we have e to the power minus st into t square. And in the second integral, we have t minus 1 into e to the power minus st. So both the functions are the functions of t. So therefore, you have to integrate by parts. So either you integrate by parts or you also know the formula for the integral of the two functions. If we say that our first function is u and the second function is v, so you can also use this direct relation also, that u is written as it is, v1 means you have to integrate your v function. That is the first integral. V1 is first integral. So u into v1 minus u dash. U dash means first differentiation. So first order differentiation of u, and it is v2. V2 means you have to integrate it twice. So this is double integration. Then the sign changes, negative becomes positive, and you have double differentiation of u function. So u will be differentiated and v will be integrated. So u into v1 minus u dash into v2 plus u double dash into v3 minus u triple dash into v4 and so on. So whichever method you feel comfortable, you can apply it. Either you see, recognize your first function and second function and put according to the islet and solve the equation, or you can use this direct relation also. So I have used the direct relation. So now my first function is t square. So t square is as it is integral of the second function. So e to the power minus st ka integral is e to the power minus st upon minus s. Then minus comes u dash. U dash means t square ka derivative. So t square ka derivative kya hota hai? 2t into e to the power minus st. Aapka v2 karna hai humne. So double integral. So kya hoga? E to the power st upon minus s. Phir se e to the power minus st upon minus s. So e to the power minus st upon minus e to the power minus st upon minus s. Then u double dash jab karna hai. So t square ka kiya to 2t aa jayega. 2t का फिर से इंटेग्रल करो, डिफरेंशियल करोगे तो क्या आएगा? t आ जाएगा. t का 1 हो गया तो आपका 2 बच जाएगा. सो u डबल डैश इज 2 एंड v3 विल बी e टू द पावर माइनस st अपॉन माइनस s का होल क्यूब. उसके बाद जब डिफरेंशियल करोगे तो 2 का डिफरेंशियल 0 हो गया तो वो खत्म हो गया. तो आपके ये तीन टर्म्स आ गई. सो नाउ यू विल put the limit 0 to 2, upper limit minus lower limit. Similarly, we do it for the second integral. Now our u function is t minus 1. So t minus 1 as it is, first integral of e to power minus st is e to the power minus st upon minus s. Then minus of t ki power t minus 1 ka differential 1 aa gaya, kyunki minus 1 ka differential 0 ho gaya. So t minus 1 ka kya ban gaya? 1. e to the power minus st ka double integral ban gaya e to the power minus st upon minus s ka whole square. Again, when you double differentiate your t minus 1, it will be 0. So you get only two terms. Then substitute the value 2 to 3. And the third integral is 8 e to the power minus st. 8 is constant. It comes out of the integral. You have just a single term e to the power minus st. So integrating e to the power minus st, you get 8 into e to the power minus e ki power minus st by minus s, and you put the limits from 3 to infinity. Ab to bas aapne kya karna hai? Now you have to just solve upper limit minus lower limit. Jahan jahan pe bhi t hai, wahan wahan pe aap values put karte jayenge. So you see, in t square you get 2 square e to the power minus 2s upon minus s, minus 2 into t, t ki jaga 2 aa gaya, e to the power minus 2s upon minus s ka whole square kya ban gaya, plus s square. Then plus 2 e to the power minus 2s upon minus s ka cube. Now we have to put the lower limit, saath mein sign change hote jayenge. So you get t square mein 0 put kiya to 0 ho gaya. Yahan pe bhi t hai second term mein 2t mein, again it comes out to be 0. In the third term you get anything raised to power 0 is 1. So you get plus 2 upon s cube e ki power minus of 0s. Kyunki denominator mein aapka minus s cube tha and 1 negative is because of the lower limit. So minus minus becomes plus. So you get plus 2 by s cube e to the power minus 0s. Similarly, we put the limits of 3 and 2 in the second. 3 minus 1 e to the power minus 3s upon minus s. Minus of e to the power minus 3s upon s square. Minus of 2 minus 1 e to the power minus 2s upon minus s. Plus e to the power minus 2s upon s square. Then we put the limit infinity and 3. And always remember that the exponential should have a negative sign if we have to put the limit of infinity, because e to the power minus infinity is 0 and e to the power plus infinity is infinity. So we always take a negative sign when we have to put a infinity value. So it is 8 e to the power minus infinity upon minus s minus of e to the power minus 3s upon s. So you get e to the power infinity is 0. So this term gets cancelled. So you can solve it. You will get these resultant terms. Now collecting the terms of e to the power minus 3s, e to the power minus 2s and constants. So you get e to the power minus 3s is 6s minus 1 by s square. E to the power minus 2s into minus 2 minus 3s minus 3s square upon s cube plus 2 by s cube. So this is how your Laplace transform is working.